Hey everyone, my name is Kajal and welcome to my channel. In today's video, we will learn to make a robot that can solve mazes using the wall following logic. We will start by building the maze in Webots, followed by understanding the wall following logic and then coding it in Python. I've included the timings here and in the description below. This is a gentle reminder to hit the bell notification when you hit subscribe so you're notified every time I come up with a new video. Without further ado, let's get into it. Let's start by creating a new project. Click on the menu bar, Wizards, New Project Directory. Click Continue. Give your project a name. I'm calling it Wall Follower Robot. Click Continue. Give a name to your world. I'm calling mine world_maze. Make sure to select Add a Rectangular Arena and click Continue. Click Done and this will load a new world with a rectangle arena. We'll start by increasing the size of our arena. Click on the rectangular arena on the scene tree. Click on Floor Size. Make X and Y is equal to 2. Next, we'll add a robot in our Webots world. To do this, click on the plus sign. Next, type epoch in the search bar. Select the epoch robot and click add to add the robot. Make sure to save your work. Next, we'll create our maze using walls. Once again, click on the plus sign and type wall in the search bar. Select wall and click on add to add this wall to our Webots world. As you can see, it created a huge wall. Let's change the size. Click on the wall in your scene tree on the left hand side. Select size and change y is equal to 0.1 meter and z is equal to 0.01 meter. To make it easy to reshape the wall or any object in Webots, let's add the coordinate system. From the menu bar, select View, Optional Rendering and Show Coordinate System. To rotate the wall, click on Rotation option under Wall on the scene tree. With x equal to 0, y equal to 1, z equal to 0, make your angle equal to 1.57 radians. Next, let's move the wall by changing the translation values. Let's make x equal to minus 0.07 meter. Let's add another wall. Select wall and use keyboard shortcut to copy and duplicate it by pasting. Once again, by changing the translation and rotational values, you can move the wall in different configurations. Using multiple walls, you can build your own maze. If you want to use the maze shown in this video, you can download it from the link in the description below. With our maze built, we will now create a controller in Python. Click on the Webots menu bar, Wizards, New Robot Controller. Click Continue and select Python as programming language. Click Continue and give a name to your controller. I'm calling it My Controller Wall Follower. Click Continue and Done. Make sure to change the controller code for epoch. Go to the Webots scene tree and select epoch. Under epoch, click on controller. In the bottom, click on select and then choose your file from the controller choice menu. Click OK and make sure to save your work. With that, let's start writing our controller code in Python. Start with creating a main function and creating a robot instance. Next, we'll create a function called runRobot to write our wall following logic. Let's look at the epoch robot configuration on the Webots website. As you can see, we have two motors called left wheel motor and right wheel motor. We also have 8 proximity sensors named PS0 to PS8. In our code, let's enable both the motors and all the sensors. I've covered this concept in a previous tutorial. I'll add the link in the cards on the corner and in the description below. For now, I'm speeding up the video. From the Webots documentation, we can also get the max speed for epoch, and let's add the same to our code. Next, let's look into detecting the walls next to epoch in our Webots world using the proximity sensors. To do this, let's read and print the readings from our proximity sensors. Also, make sure to give speed to both the motors so our robot can drive forward. Save the code and click on the play button to start the Webot simulation. To view the sensor rays, click on View, Optional Rendering, and Show Distance Sensor Rays. The green rays indicate an object is detected, which in this case is the wall. Let's pull up the epoch documentation on Webots website. We can see that this is the PS5 sensor, and from the terminal output, we can also get the values being read by this sensor. We can use all of this information to update our code to detect walls on the left side of epoch. Let's call that the left wall. Similarly, we can detect a wall in front of the epoch using proximity sensor PS7. Let's call that the front wall. Now let's understand the wall following logic that will be used to solve the maze. As the name suggests, the robot will follow a wall. You can choose a side. I'm choosing left. The robot has to drive in such a way to follow the left wall. When the wall is on its left and there is nothing in front of the robot, it can simply drive forward. If it detects a wall in front of the robot, it is essentially in a corner. It should drive right to continue. Now, if there is an upcoming left turn, the wall on the left side will disappear. So if there is no wall on the left, the robot has to take left. And the same concept will also work for a U-turn. This brings us to the last case. That is, there is no wall on the left-hand side and there is a wall in front of the robot. Since we are following the left wall, our robot needs to turn such that the wall is on the left side. This can be done by simply turning right on the spot. Let's code the wall following logic. We'll start by creating two speeds, each for left and right motor. Epoch is a differential drive robot. I've explained how to drive a differential drive robot in a previous video. I'll add a link to that video in the card on the corner and in the description below. We can start with the common action of turning right in place when there is a wall in front of the robot, irrespective of if a wall exists on the left side or not. Next, if a wall is detected on the left, we drive forward. And if none of the walls are detected, we turn left. Let's try the speed 1/4 of max for left and full speed for right. Let's test the code. Click on the play sign to run the Webot simulation. As you can see, the robot is following the left wall. However, after turning, it ends up too close to the wall. Let's reduce the speed to see if that helps. Make sure to save your work and let's run the simulation again. Once again, it still comes too close to the wall. If we look at the sensor rays, we can see both PS5 and PS6 detect the wall. We can use this information to ensure our robot doesn't end up coming too close to the wall or touching it. Let's go back to the code and use this information. We'll call this the left corner. If the left corner is detected, the robot is too close to the wall and should drive away from it by turning right. Make sure to save the code and let's run the Webot simulation again. As you can see, the robot is easily following the wall, and after turning, it didn't come too close to the robot. I will slow down here and run the simulation one step at a time so we can observe what happens when the robot is in a corner. Let me show you another scenario. In this next scenario, we have an upcoming left turn and a narrow U-turn. Once again, the robot continues to follow the left wall and drive its way around the maze. If you enjoyed this tutorial, make sure to give it a like. This will encourage me to make more such videos. And if you haven't already, don't forget to subscribe and hit the bell notification. Also, if you have any questions or doubts, use the comment section below. Thank you for watching, and I'll see you in the next video.